and Mia's members since day one of their encounters with Mia, and of course all throughout the year through Mia YCS efforts. Mia is certainly at the forefront of advocating corporate sustainability and Ateneo. But are we really in for advocating CS? If we remember the balloons at the fair that got stuck in trees. It shows that some people really don't think that we genuinely practice corporate sustainability. And though we can advocate corporate sustainability as an organization, are our members personally advocating it? Sustainability is at its most widespread now, but at the same time, Mayans can feel like corporate sustainability is a membership requirement rather than their own advocacy. And we have to reconcile this need to not make sustainability forced, at the same time, genuinely advocate it. So I'm Sam Gutierrez, and as your VP for sustainability next year, I would like Maya to leave out to open the sleeves of corporate sustainability for Ateneo to know and to believe. And I want to do that by advocating through practice. And the first point that I would like to make here is that we have to present sustainability as a lifestyle. And this step is really for building genuine interest among the members so that the members will be the ones to approach sustainability instead of vice versa. So the CSI efforts will focus on awareness in terms of lifestyle, sustainability as lifestyle. So Mayans will be able to review social enterprises' products and processes, and we'll listen to talks about people who live a sustainable lifestyle and not just corporations that practice it. And hopefully this interest will lead to a desire for sustained education. And I say sustained because CS can't be a one-time, big-time workshop. It has to be a series of lessons that build up on each other. And the partnership with the Ateneo Institute of Sustainability will allow us this series of workshops, which conclude in being a sustainability consultant in partnership with the Mayo Consulting Group. Next is the appropriate integration of CS into Mayo's projects. Guidelines that ensure sustainability in terms of sourcing, financing, promotions will be talked about and enforced by the Central Board. There will be sections for each type of project, fundraisers, events, so that the application of CS is relevant to the project. And lastly, we want to form good relationships with other organizations. And this is the completion of advocating through practice as we partner with other organizations and communities to practice our core advocacy. For ACSC, it has been doing very well, and what we want to do with it is to increase its visibility with MEA and for it to grow to public high school participants. And for MSI, the issues for next year will really be about continuity and turnover. And for this, we'll have framework creation and mentorship so that the nanays will have more independence of their enterprise. As for the post-needs project, we will partner with an org with a similar advocacy to promote collaborative leadership and as well as the practice of CS. So my sustainability journey in MEA actually began when I first read this Slate magazine. Given that steps, and as I read the articles on social entrepreneurship and sustainability, I didn't even know that CS was the core advocacy of MEA. Call it serendipity because I entered MEA wanting to be a social entrepreneur. When I read these articles, I knew that I was in the right place, the right course, the right organization. So with these 4 points, I hope that you believe in me as I advocate sustainability through practice, and I hope you can believe in me, Sam Gutierrez, to be your next VP for sustainability. Thank you.